caught in an inescapable network of mutuality tied in a common garment of destiny. I was raised as a kid that said, my parents would tell me that you cannot forget where you've come from. My father would look at me walking around my house in this nice, spacious New Jersey home with more teenage swagger than any of your children have. And my father would look at me and say, boy, don't you dare walk around this house like you hit a triple because you were born on third base. You're the beneficiary. You're the beneficiary of extraordinary love. You're the beneficiary of compassion. You are the living manifestation of a conspiracy of love. But what my parents would challenge me with, saying you can't pay it back, when it comes to issues of justice, righteousness, mercy, and compassion, you can't pay that back. You've got to find ways to pay it forward. And the challenge for me to find people of like minds and spirits and energy and join them in a larger cause. It helps people to understand that we've got to raise the moral imagination of this country, that we've got to prick the consciousness of others to get them to care as much for the people sitting around them at their tables as we do for the people in the kitchen washing the dishes we just ate from. That understanding that we have a collective destiny shouldn't just stop at other human beings. It shouldn't just stop at food service workers. It shouldn't just stop at people. It should go beyond that, that this destiny, this interwoven destiny that we all share, is also about our planet, about our environment, and about animals as well. And so I tell you this, that I have parents that taught me to trust people. Don't surrender to cynicism about people. Cynicism is a refuge of cowards. It almost says that you should wash your hands of responsibility to take action because there's nothing you can do to change it. Well, that's just not the case. In the United States Senate, I feel happy. A friend of mine joked with me after I became vegan and said, screw the fact that you're the fourth ever elected African American to the United States Senate. You're the first vegan ever in the Senate. The greatness of an individual should never be judged by the heights that they attain. It should never be judged by personal accomplishment. It should be judged by a person's willingness to do for others. That service is the measure. Service is the measure with which people are great. And so that's whether it's a woman on a bus who is humble of stature but refuses to get up, she is a great person. And it's also when a person from perches that are seen by millions still is passionate and concerned, as the Bible says, by the least of these, that is greatness. The Stewarts are amazing individuals, and I am so proud tonight to be able to introduce this video. And I will say this one thing, I had to change us politicians, we have a few go-to jokes. And I used to have this joke, which is less how I'm gonna be able to tell it. I used to say, when I came home as mayor, hard day's work, when I felt beat down by the world, I would come home to my empty apartment and biological experiments going on in my refrigerator as a bachelor. And I used to say that I would curl up on the couch and hang out in an intimate menage with some of my closest friends. And I used to tell people that those friends were Ben and Jerry and Jon Stewart. But I'm a vegan now. Have come tonight, that they are living the great ideal of service, that was the reason why I am here, that they are a part now of this incredible conspiracy of love that continues our country and our growth in compassion and love. Thank you very much.